Let's look at how easy it is to key a shot in motion. So here I have a video clip of Justine on a green background. Let's move to a frame where we really see her hair flying about here. I'm going to go to the library, to filters, to the keying category, and apply the keyer to this clip. And it immediately removes the background. I can tell by going up to the channels pop-up menu and choosing transparent, and we can see we've got transparency. So we can put any background there we'd like. Let's go back to the colored background. Now that does a good job. Let's toggle it off and on. But let's see if we can do a little bit better job to get a little more hair detail in here by creating a manual key. So to do that, in the inspector, we have several views here. The first view, which is selected, is the composite view, which shows us the key applied. The second is the matte view. Anything that's white is opaque or visible. Anything that's black is invisible, and shades of gray are partially visible. And the third view is the original view of the clip without the keyer applied. So let's go back to the composite view, and I'm going to make the strength slider 0. Doing this allows us to pull a manual key by removing the automatic key. I'll click the sample color swatch here, and I'll click to drag out a sample. Our green screen is very evenly lit, so doing so really cuts out all of the green except the little corners here, and we'll deal with that in a moment. But her hair still looks pretty thick, so now I'll go to the edges tile and drag out across her hair and adjust this slider as well as the endpoints to get some more detail in her hair. Now I want to go back to the matte view because I want to make sure that I'm not introducing transparency into the overall figure. These areas of gray mean they're partially transparent. So I need to back off on that so we don't have any areas of gray. We have a nice full white fill here. Right about there. And now we have a nice key where we've got a little more hair detail. I'll turn that off and on. Now to deal with these corners, what I'll do is I'll move the playhead back home. I'm going to select the Bezier Mask tool. And I'm going to click drag to add several control points and draw a quick mask around Justine here. Then I'll scrub through the clip to make sure the mask doesn't cut anything off. We see it cutting off her hand, so I'll just move that out. And that mask, if we turn off the keyer, we can see that it now hides the areas that are more difficult to key. That's called a garbage mat. I'll turn the keyer back on. And very quickly, we've created a very nice manual key on our shot of Justine, which is now ready to be placed on a background. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.